I never realized how much I came to rely on the light that came through this front window in the morning, because normally I film in the morning and I'm filming in the afternoon and the sun's like on the other side of the house. So I just feel like my lighting is all off. So I apologize. Hey there, my name is Megan and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing the book dating history tag. I was tagged by Nico over at Nico's Book Reviews, who is the coolest. So I'll go ahead and link his channel up in the cards as well as in the description. So definitely make sure that you go check his channel out. But this tag seems like a lot of fun, so thank you so much for tagging me, Nico. But before we go ahead and get on into the prompts, if you are not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, as well as the little bell icon so you can be notified every time I post new bookish content. I post new videos every Monday, Wednesday, Saturday, and sometimes other days throughout the week. Also, don't forget to check down in the description box for links to my social media, my Discord, and my Patreon, where you can be entered into winning book giveaways. Prompt number one is first loves. What is the book that was your first love? So I have a bunch of books that I remember from childhood absolutely loving or series that got me into reading, but the one I'm actually going to choose is The True Confessions of Charlotte Doyle by AV. This book just stuck out to me as a child. I don't remember how old I was when I read it, but I remember being on the couch and reading it and just being so engrossed with the story. It's about a girl named Charlotte who ends up getting put on a ship to go back to America, and she gets involved in like a mutinous crew plot, and she doesn't know if the captain is trustworthy, and she ends up getting accused of murder, and it's just so much fun, and it really ignited my love for books that take place on the ocean and sailing. And it's a book that I really enjoy reading even as an adult. It's a book that I have read with my students in the past, so definitely a book that stands the test of time and one that I love even from childhood. Prompt two is outside your genre. What is a favorite book that's outside the genre that you read? So I do read a decent amount of genres. I don't really read a lot of horror, mystery. I don't read a lot of contemporary romance or contemporary in general. And I might be cheating by going with this, but I'm gonna go with Radiance by, I think it's Grace Draven is her name. And this is a fantasy, but it's romance. And it is heavy romance with like a hint of like smut. Actually, not a hint of smut, a lot of smut. And this book I got on Kindle several years ago, and like I gobbled this book up. It was so good. I'm not usually one that really reads like smutty romance, especially fantasy. I don't think I've ever read a fantasy romance, so I would consider this book out of my genre. Prompt three is catfishing. What is a book that catfished you, and was it good or bad? I'm gonna go with The Queen of the Tearling by Erica Johansson. And I originally got this book because I really liked the cover. The blurb sounded like something I really like. The reviews were really good. And this is probably one of my least favorite books of all time. So I was catfished by the cover. I was catfished by the blurb, and it just didn't live up to my expectations. Prompt four is, does size really matter? What's more important to you, the length of the book or the ocean of emotion? And I'm gonna have to say the ocean of emotion. A good example of this is Mem by Bethany C. Morrow. This book is barely 200 pages long, and this book made me tear up so bad, and it was so emotional and so heart-gripping and so good. And then you have books like Brandon Sanderson that are 1,200 page chunkers that I also really love because there's so much world building and character development, and you get so attached to the story. So I guess in the end, both, but size definitely matters. Prompt five is out of your league. What is a book that was out of your league, but you went for it anyway? And I'm actually going to go with Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen for this. I attempted to read this the first time when I was about 16 years old. I really struggled with the writing, the vocabulary. I think at the time I wasn't used to reading books from that time period and in that writing style, so I just didn't connect with it at all. However, I have reread it as an adult, and I've also reread Sense and Sensibility and absolutely loved them. Prompt six is kiss, marry, kill. Name three books, one that you would kiss, one that you would marry, and one that you would kill. For kiss, I'm gonna go with The Black Prism by Brent Weeks, specifically Gavin Giles. He's just like, I could totally kiss Gavin Giles. He is definitely a big contributor to why I love this series so much. He's one of my favorite morally gray characters, and just, oh, I love him so much. And the way Brent Weeks described him, he's like a super hottie in my mind. For Mary, I'm gonna go with Blood Song by Anthony Ryan, just because Valen is just the sweetest character. Like, I just wanna give him a hug. Like, he's got a good, sweet heart, but he's got a rough kind of exterior. He's been through a lot and he has to make tough decisions. Plus, I loved Blood Song. It's one of my favorite books of all time, so. And Kill, I'm gonna have to go with Malice by John Gwynne. I really didn't feel a connection to any one of these characters particularly, and I feel like this book was way more boring than it was engaging for me personally. It was hard for me to get through, and I did end up liking the ending and how it leads into the second book, which I'm currently reading. But just the lack of interesting characters, in my opinion, kind of makes me want to kill Malice. Prompt 7 is The Ex You Can't Let Go Of, What's a Book You Keep Going Back To, and this is a series that I've been contemplating if I want to unhaul or not, and that is the Fifth Wave Trilogy by Rick Yancey. It's a young adult sci-fi series about an alien invasion, and I really like the Fifth Wave. I like the characters, I like the concept, it had kind of like an apocalyptic feel to it. And then we got to the second book, which I didn't like that much, and then we got to the third book, which I absolutely hated. So I keep asking myself why I'm holding on to the series if I didn't like two out of the three books. Prompt 8 is The Bad Boy or Girl. Name a book on your shelf that has a bad boy or girl character, and I'm gonna go with Luce from The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. Luce is some sort of demon that puts a spell on Addie, and it's a very cruel spell, but yet there is like severe sexual tension between Addie and this character, and a lot of stuff happens between them to the point where they are the only two people that understand each other, can, I don't want to say rely on each other, but they're the only two people around that understand what the other person's going through, so it does create a bond between them, even though it is toxic, and it was just a really interesting relationship dynamic. Luce is definitely not a good character, but he did add a bit of like heat to the story. Prompt 9 is Friend Zone. What is a book that you know will be a good read, but you've put it down in order to read something else for now? And this is so funny because they just did this. I'm going to go with Valor by John Gwynne. I am halfway through this book and I'm putting it down in order to read Fool's Errand and The Lies of Locke Lamora. And The Lies of Locke Lamora is a reread for me too, which is kind of bad, but definitely the Robin Hobb book. And I'm struggling to get into this. I know I'm going to finish it. I want to finish it. I'm sure that it will be good in the end. I've heard awesome things about the next two books in the series. I'm just struggling for now. So I'm friend zoning Valor. And prompt 10 is to tag people. I'm going to tag anybody who's watching this video and wants to do this tag. Let me know in the comments if you're going to be doing it so I can watch it. Also, what your answer to some of these prompts might be. And I will see y'all soon in another video. Goodbye. Thank you.